In this video segment, we're going to take a look at the cabinet features available in the Home Designer Pro product. Let's begin the process by comparing the cabinet dialog from Home Designer Pro to our lower end products. You're going to notice that there's an option for box construction, fill style, label, components, and object information. Let's begin at the general component and start looking at some of the added features you're going to find in Home Designer Pro. Not only will you find more panels available in Home Designer Pro, you're also going to find more depth in the existing panels. On the general panel, one of the first things I'm going to point out is corner treatment for the cabinet itself. Let's go ahead and zoom in on this area of the cabinet, and I'm going to change the corner treatment to clipped, and I'm going to set it to be 1 inch in clipping. And you can see in the diagram in here how it clips. You can also change it to be rounded, so if you want to have it rounded, and you can control that setting right down in this area. Other setting that you have available in Home Designer Pro is on the toe kick with the closed toe and always present option. You'll notice in the 3D view the closed toe is only available on the ends of this cabinet run. By checking always present, it will force that closed toe when we close the dialog to be included in between each of the breaks, and I would actually want to make that setting for all of those cabinets. Box construction is another significant added feature you'll find in Home Designer Pro. You can change your cabinets from a framed to a frameless. You can control the overlay information, if it's full overlay, and if it's inset. Again, those are settings that you can change, and as you change those, you can control exactly how that cabinet box will lay out. On the front panel of the cabinet, if we change our view back here and zoom out a little bit, there is a feature on the front of the cabinet where you can click on a face item. Let me zoom out a little bit. And if I were to change this to, let's say, a drawer, you'll find an option to split these face items. Here's a split horizontal, here's a split vertical, and you can control how those face items are created. You can create very interesting cabinets, maybe a custom vanity or an entertainment center by using those tools. You can also click on the top of the panel, use the equalize button, and it will space those face items out equally across the item. Make sure that when you do this equalize, none of the face items have been locked. Any face item that is locked will not resize when you use the equalize function. Fill style is something that you can control the fill style. This is typically for your plan view. You can see how that fill style applies. There's a light pink color in the default. The label panel, this gives you added control over the default label. Currently I've got it set to be automatic. You can suppress the label, or you can specify a label and type in an exact information about that label. There's a components panel. This shows you a breakdown of the entire cabinet box. You can come in here, you can type in pricing information, you can put a supplier in, and allows you to get very detailed information about the specific cabinet you are designing. There's also an object information panel. Again, a little bit more added information if you're going to be doing details about your cabinets for codes, comments, description, manufacturer, and supplier. This is all data available to help you get exact information for a kitchen or a bath or other room you may be designing with custom cabinets. If you take a look at the wall cabinets we have in the design, notice the center wall cabinet has two different door styles and hardware components on that. That's an added feature you're going to find in Home Designer Pro. If I select the cabinet on the left, I'm going to change the height of this to be 51 inches. Click on the front of the door. I'm going to use the split horizontal feature. Take the upper component. I'm going to size that face item to be 15 inches. And then I'm going to go in and specify exactly what appliance door or drawer style, in this case the door style. Inside of this dialog, I'm going to browse out to the library, and I'll just choose a simple recess panel door. You can also choose to be frame doors, and in this case if I check glass, you can control it. The next thing I want to change is the door hardware in here. So you can come over to the door handle, again, browse back out to the library. And I'll just grab a different style of hardware that I can apply onto that cabinet door. You can control the spacing of it. Notice that the change in from bottom is 10 inches. I'll just set that to be 1.5 inches. You see the preview of it, and now I can create a cabinet with two different door styles as well as different hardware on those doors. Make sure you refer to our support articles on more information about cabinets. Also in the cabinet dialog, the help function is context sensitive. It will open up immediately to the area of the help about cabinets. You'll see a numbered listing, and you can scroll down this and find out detailed information about every panel inside of the cabinet dialog to learn more.